Yeah.
So when we move on to intelligence, we're talking about intelligence, okay? Now, Henry Ford II, we've all known about Ford Motors, okay? And Doe was the pioneer behind Ford Motors, and he was the one who was the entire story behind Ford Motors. What did he do? And then he let things slip after his son died, and it moved into bankruptcy. Henry Ford too was called in, okay, and to get things back into the helm, and he took over as the chairman of Ford Motors Company, and pulling it right from the brink of bankruptcy, he takes it to a being a one of the topmost in houses in the country. So now he has Saturn, and it is the Lagna Lord, and it represents the self. It is placed, it is also the second lord of wealth, and it's placed in the seventh house of your secondary house of career and profession. And it's seventh house as 10th to 10th, it's also honor. Okay, and it is associated again with the 11th lord of gains. So there we find a very strong happening with this. Now we would move on to, instead of the story of Janmajaya, okay, well, let's see the Janmajaya story, which is very, very beautiful. So let's move on to Janmajaya story is Yagna of Janmajaya. We all know that Janmajaya is the son of Parikshit. How well, who was Parikshit? Parikshit was the grandson of Arjun. And after the Battle of Mahabharata, when Arjun and his brothers went off to pilgrimage and they took their end, okay, they left their human bodies, they had, before going, crowned Parikshit as the king. Now, when Parikshit was crowned as a king, he did not, his acts were so pious and so definitive that he did not allow Kaliyug to move into his kingdom. Now, Kaliyug was very upset because time waits for none. We know time and tide wait for none. So time has to move according to its own cycle. So Kaliyug approaches Parikshit and says that I will that and Parikshit says that you are the worst form of a Yuga. I will kill you. Kaliyug says, don't do that. You are playing with the laws of nature. And he was Parikshit was powerful enough to do that. He said, you're playing with the power, with the laws of nature. I have to get into this kingdom because my time has come. You need to tell me the five things that I can get into. So of the five things that he got place in, one of them was gold. And I'll stress on a point here. We all know that the Christian nuns and even the fathers, they're married to the religion, they're married to Christ. Every so, you know, in Christianity, they wear a ring, right, in the left hand to show that you are married. So, but if you see that ring for the nuns and the priest is never in gold, it is always in silver. Silver is said to be a pure metal. It's said to be a sattvic metal rather than gold. Gold has the rajasic properties, and it has the ability to modify your mind. Why? Because Kaliyug moves into people through gold also. Okay. Now, King Janmajaya had a crown on his head. So Saturn says, for me to move into the entire kingdom free at large, this king has to first go. So how do I move into him? I move in through a crown which is made up of gold. Okay, so now what he does is he gets the king to, he goes and sits on his head, and what is there on your head? Your mind. So Saturn gets debilitated there, you know that, right?
Yes.
In the first house of the natural zodiac, which is
Yes.
your mind. This king is now going, he's in a forest. He's very thirsty. He's out for a hunt. He's very thirsty and he wants to drink water. But he's not finding any water anywhere. and he comes across a rishi in a hermitage. And when he sees that rishi, he wants to drink water. He calls upon the rishi, but the rishis of yesterday were not like us. When we are meditating, we can hear 10 voices, we can do a lot of things. When they went into a meditative state, left their body and traveled astrally. So the rishi is unable to hear what the king is saying. The king has a crown. Who is sitting there? Kaliyug makes him pick up a dead snake lying on the ground and wrap it around the king's rishi's head. Now, when the rishi's son comes into picture, he is livid with anger. The rishis, they lived austerely. They lived in very, very... Now, can you see it's a snake that he puts? So, that is the reason we are doing snakes as Nagas, a devata. The rishis are very, very upset. And what does he do? They have very strong powers of penance. And he says, may the person who has had the audacity to put this snake around my father's neck die within 7 days, within 8 days. Eighth day from today, he will meet his maker. He will be bitten by a snake and he will die. Now, let's go back, way back into history. Arjun, who has married a daughter of a snake, okay, but has been one who has been instrumental in Takshak, who's another very famous snake, losing out his home and hearth, was cursed by Takshak that I will bring about an end to your dynasty. So Takshak comes to know about it. Here what has happened is Janmajaya steps in. Who is Janmajaya? Janmajaya is Parikshit's father. Okay, he says, father, I will not allow any soul to move into you. Okay, and what does he do? He says that I will simply block it all up. So they build a fortress. But if death is looming, there is nobody can stop it. So what Takshak does is, I told you, they are shape shifters and they had the powers. He takes the form of a worm, and every day somebody would carry fruits for the king. And he takes a form of a worm, tiny worm, and moves into the fruit. Will anybody notice? Nobody will notice. He moves there, and there, when the king is about to eat, it takes the form of his original form, bites the king, and leaves. Janmajaya is mad. He says, I will kill the entire population of snakes. But this cannot happen. This cannot happen. You cannot kill the entire population. This is against the laws of nature. Lord Brahma had come to rescue. There's a lot of story behind that. Let's Astika, who was a Brahmin boy. Okay, he was a Brahmin boy. Now Lord Brahma had already foreseen it, and you have to realize that the snakes were under a curse by their own mother. Who comes to help here? Here we have the snake called the first one is Ananta and Sheshnag and Takshak, the Vasuki. Vasuki comes to the help here and says, I'll protect my kin and my siblings and everybody. And so what he does is he searches for a match, a rishi boy for his Naga sister. And then it so happens, it's a long story, so we are not going fully into that. They are married, a rishi boy is found, he's married to the Naga sister, and they have a son. So because the father is a Brahmin, he becomes a Brahmin, and Astika is his name. And Astika, what he does is he pursues king, because when the yagna is taking place, the yagna had such majestic powers that the snakes were drawn towards, from all the worlds, towards this havan, and they fell into the kunda, havan kunda, and they met their end. Now, so many of these snakes, they were helpless ones. But with the power increase in the power of the Havan, the big ones also were started moving in. And that time, Astika comes to their, help. And Astika says, there has already been a forecast that this Havan may not be completed. So let nobody be enter, allow entry. But Astika is a small boy and he moves in with such a lot of aplomb that nobody has the heart to stop him. And he asks King Janmajaya for a, boon. He's half a snake himself from his mother's side. His hereditary is half a snake himself from his mother's side. So King Janmajaya gives him the boon because a king in those days did not have the right to let go of a Brahmin without giving him something. So he says that please stop this yagna. You've done enough mayhem. And that was, everybody who's come to this planet has to leave. So that was the end for your father. Understand, you need to be much more practical. And there's a lot of dialogue. And finally, the Havan is stopped. The killing of the snake is stopped. So inferences from this. Mysterious deaths, hereditary issues. Somebody from your family is there to save you. You could have a lot of curses. These people can be under a lot of, not just curses, can be under a lot of mental trauma by their own family. Can you know, we've done it in the earlier story that they were cursed by their own parent. Okay, so then we have the hypnotic eyes, substance abuse, and mysterious death of Marlon Monroe. Marlon Monroe was one of the most well-known, actresses of her time. And it is said that she died of poison. Her death was uncertain. Still today, her death has not been claimed as anything, whether it's a suicide, whether it's a murder, whatever. It so happened that she was found in her bed, she was not clothed, and she had a telephone in her hand. Her housekeeper calls the police, but no matter how hard they search, none of her personal notes or diaries were seen. And ascendant here is Ashlesha. She'd gone through a lot in life. This lady has a very tumultuous beginning also. And she grew up under very dire circumstances. She has a retrograde Saturn, which is the lord of the 8th house, of Akal Mrityu, looking into the 10th aspect on her Lagna, which is in Ashlesha. Fortifies it on a number of points. We talked about hereditary. Now, see, hereditary, okay. So I'll just take up one point, hereditary, drug abuse also. She had a problem with alcohol. Her mother and her grandmother also had the same problem. Okay, and now let's take up Nona Ricci. Nona Ricci, she was an Italian actress and she came from a family which generations were into theater. Her father, her mother, her husband, everybody. And here what do we have? We have Mercury, which is house Mercury owns. Mercury owns the 5th house of creativity and 8th house of transformation right there in her 6th house of service, 6th house of discretion, 6th house. And 6th house here is in Ashlesha Nakshatra. That knowledge. Robin Armstrong. So, one point I think most of you would be very interested in knowing is the effect of this nakshatra takes place between the ages 18 and 20. Queen Elizabeth II requires no introduction. She was inducted as a as the princess, as the queen, when her father passed away, and on her 18th birthday, Parliament changed the law so that she could act as one of the five councillors of the state in the event of an incapacity of her father, because either he would be abroad or he would have not been able to assess that. So, such as his visit to Italy in July 1944. She was inducted as one of the five councillors at the age of 18. She, in February 1945, at the height of the World War II, she trained as a driver and mechanic. Okay, and she was promoted to honorary junior commander 5 months later. She still, at till 70, 80, she still used to drive her own car many a times in her estate. Moon is the eighth lord of legacy or inheritance. As she approached her 18th birthday, Parliament changed the laws so that she could be one of the five councillors. That's also legacy. That's also house, eighth house of transformation. So the laws were transformed or laws were changed for her. Okay. And you also have the aspect of an exalted Mars. And what is Mars? Mars is the fifth house of power, fifth lord of power, and 12th lord of international faith. So a lot of things, psychic abilities, when people have their they have their key planets, so that you could encounter with spirits or you know how to handle them. Crescent, he was an American mentalist, and he was noted that in a mass he could suggest mind reading and calling on the spirits. He was known as the Amazing Crescent. Okay, and he had a full page ad in the Globe selling his 6 super secrets to bring success. And what does he have? He has his ascendant there, and ascendant is the fourth pada of Ashlesha. If I take it in the Navamsh, it would fall in Pisces, which again is the supernatural powers. And Ketu is sitting in the Lagna. When Ketu sits in the Lagna, it gives you a very strong connect with the spiritual and the psychic world. Okay, and the Lagna here we can see is aspected by Venus and Mercury. Rahu is a given because Ketu is sitting there. Venus and Mercury. Again, Mercury is the 12th lord of the spiritual world. Okay. So we'll take up just one more point here, and we'll go with Ashlesha and destructions. If we've seen the venomous part of the nakshatras, okay, of this nakshatra of Ashlesha. So, and you've seen in the stories what they can do to change a life of a person completely altogether. So if this is afflicted, the nature will destroy the reputation or career of a few people at the very least. So we, Mahatma Gandhi, he destroyed his enemies. It's said that the sun never set on the British kingdom empire. He was the first one to pull out the rug from under their feet, and then all came tumbling after. So Mahatma Gandhi was responsible for destroying the British rule in India. You see, Moon, which is the lord of the 10th house, so it's a very strong house there. It is with sitting in Ashlesha Nakshatra, and it is sitting with Rahu, another planet of foreign planet. And what did he do? It's aspecting the 4th house of homeland. He drove away the foreigners from his homeland. So this is destruction. Coming to much in newer history, we know about Julian Assange. Mercury. What, Mercury is the 8th lord of transformation in his chart. What does he do? He changes things over for them.
Wow.
And you know what he's done. We all know what Julian Assange has done. He has laid people threadbare on the social media. For that, he's he's ruined the career of many, and he's facing a lot of flake, a lot of problems because of that. But that's secondary. He's made sure that many people are leading unsettled lives. And Mercury is the eighth lord of secrecy. Also, it's in the it's conjoined Ketu. Ketu, again, a spiritual planet, and it's there in the ninth house of publication. Ninth house, fifth house, they're all publicating houses. And his WikiLeaks, we know what has done to the world at large. We've covered a theme called sexuality, sensuality with Ashlesha Nakshatra. So if this is, if the focal planets for sex are Venus and Mars, if they are in Ashlesha and they are afflicted, the person might show sexual imbalances or perversion, excess or too less. Michael Jackson had his Venus. We shouldn't speak ill about the death. It's the sixth house. He has been categorically many a times been under a lot of observation, under a lot of flake, under a lot of cloud because of his association, not so correct association with children. Venus is also the fourth lord of emotions, and it is also the ninth lord of parent. So probably somewhere along the line, he's failed as a parent. And many children have lodged complaints. If you read that, you would find that in Wikipedia also. So let's move on to symbology. They are shape shifting. We did an example of shape shifting with Taksha. They're very manipulative. They have hidden agenda. They're deadly. They're quiet. And they catch people by surprise. Have you seen a snake move? Does it make a lot of noise? It's one of the most graceful animal, the way it moves. You can be hypnotized just by its movement. It never travels straight. It is always moving in a zigzag manner. It always, snake will wait to catch its, prey. It will hypnotize them before it moves into them. We've done deadly quiet. Let me go back to one of my favorite examples. Very unassuming. Hitler. He rose through ranks, and he was so unassuming. He had a very strong power, and he was deadly. People would be so afraid of him. So just by a look of him, people would they could die at that spot. That kind of fear he instilled in people. And he was very suspicious. Snakes are very suspicious. They're nobody's friend. Hitler was very, very suspicious a person. Planet is Mercury. It's intelligent, sharp, self-preservative, ambitious, and nervous. I have already stated, so one of the things that it shares with the snakes is a nervous disposition. Mercury also is very ambitious. Snakes are also very ambitious, very intelligent, as Mercury the planet is, and equally ambitious. So what are the Purushartha, very surprisingly, is Dharma. But if it is afflicted, their sense of dharma can be very distorted. Look at his sense of dharma. Look at, let's go back. Okay, let's see the sense of dharma of, if you remember, of our very good, again, Hitler example. He has Saturn sitting there, right? So this is a malefic planet which is afflicting this nakshatra. And so he considers as the purpose of his life. what he considers as a part of righteousness need not be everybody else's work, but then he thinks it's his dharma, so he's doing what is correct. We move on to Trimurti. This I want to lay stress on. Why? Because the Trimurti principle here is Shiva, dynamism. No matter what, you have to give it to the gentleman there, Hitler, that Adolf Hitler, that he was dynamic. There was a radical amount of transformation during his reign, and he was extremely disciplined. If you read the books about the Nazis, you will realize the amount of paperwork they did and the amount of work they did to make sure that everything around was absolutely accounted for, prim and proper. They did not have any care for human life, but their paperwork, their administration mattered to them. And that was something instilled in them by Hitler. Vehicle of Goddess Lakshmi, ability to discern facts is something you have in a spotted owlet. The call is harsh and loud, associated with bad omens. But if it's a white, you know, if there is a white, absolutely white owl, then it is harbinger of good news and Lakshmi, which is well. So animal is a male cat. We use these animal symbology. We use this animal symbology for, you know, our taking up in analysis in Nakshatra, we do that, and compatibility for people. So we move on to, let's move on to some remedial measures. The first remedial measures is the Bij Mantra. Okay, you have the Om Gam, Gayatri Mantra. I would never ask people to go into doing Bij Mantras, rather do the Vishnu Sahasrana. This falls into the four padas of Vishnu Sahasranam. You would get it in your book. When you start from the first sloka, and when you do, if your moon is in the first pada, do the first, second pada, second, third or fourth, take up the Vishnu Sahasranam, and 9 fours are 36. So 32 to 36 falls for these next padas of Ashlesha. Remedial measures, give milk in Shiva temple. You can keep it there, or you can do a Shiva Abhishek. You can throw a little milk in the sea, and that is from another story. You can feed milk to a male cat, okay, or a combination of Chandra and Mercury. So we also have the gods and goddesses with the temple in Tamil Nadu, in Tanjore district. For people who want to go there, this is the description available. And there is a contact number also, so you can contact the temple and you can also go there, do your pujas if this nakshatra is afflicted for you, and take the blessings of the god and goddesses so that your karma is a little reduced.
And Tanjavur also has this famous Brihadeshwara temple. It's Lord Shiva's temple. Amazing it is.
Yeah.
It's three times, I think.
So, Tanjore has a lot of temples.
Yes, yes, yes. And that river is also there. I forgot it's Narmada or Kaveri. I think it's Kaveri. I don't know. Maybe it's Narmada. Anyways. No, it's Kaveri, I think. Or Krishna. I'm a bit confused. Anyways, amazing it was. So whoever is watching this, they will be able to understand maybe what all things they need to take care of if they have planets there in Ashlesha. And even if they don't have, then the eclipse is coming on 11th. So we can take care that we do not gossip or we do not spread poison about others now, or try to pull others down or try to behave the way this nakshatra
we cannot. Yeah, we are not manipulative. We are if you focus this, it has a lot of positive energy and it can be focused into a very beautiful direction also. Intelligence, we've seen in number of people. Michael Jackson had a lot of intelligence. Marilyn Monroe also had very beautiful intelligence. There are a lot of people here who are very intelligent. Unfortunately, because this nakshatra or Mercury or any planet sitting there is, what did Mahatma Gandhi do? He saved his nation. So one intelligence we see is working on a in a very positive and a very higher octave, and the other intelligence is working on a very lower octave. That is our choice.
Yeah,
that is our choice.
Nakshatra will have some positives and some
negatives.
We always have to see how we can tap into the potential.
And one more thing is, higher the highs, the lower the lows. Always remember.
Anyways, thank you very much for your time, and whoever is watching this, I would say you can go to her channel and subscribe if you have not. And there's some amazing videos, and you have this 6-7 minute snippets on each nakshatras. So they are amazing videos, and you have also made videos on the eclipses, I guess. And
yes.
Your course is also going on, and if anybody wants, they can contact you for that. I will put your the description of your website and your YouTube channel in the description and comments of this video. So I hope whoever is watching this, everybody just goes and subscribes.
Thank you so much, Babaji. Thank you so very much.
And maybe the next nakshatra we will do will be Rohini, because Lord Krishna's appearance.
Janmashtami is on the way. Yes, definitely.
Yeah, 2nd September. So maybe somewhere in August we will launch that video. Janmashtami special.
Yes, we'll do that with a lot of pomp and show.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I'll stop now.